What's up, Christ United kids? Are you ready to practice our Bible verse for today, for this entire week? It's such a fun one. All right, are you ready? Proverbs 27:17. As iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. Let's just do it again because it's so fun. Proverbs 27:17. As iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. Awesome. Great job. You guys are getting so good at writing God's word on your heart. And we've been learning that iron sharpening iron just means encouraging for, praying for, helping the people around us to know that God loves them. Grab your Bibles. And we are in 1 Thessalonians 3. Oh, no, just kidding. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. All right, this is a super short verse, but it tells us exactly what we need to know about what it means for iron to sharpen iron. It says, therefore, encourage one another and build each other up. Encourage one another and build each other up. All right? So we're going to talk about that right now. I want you to think about what are some ways that we can give encouragement to people that we know that love Jesus. But guys, even when we love Jesus, there are going to be times when we're having a bad day or when we're sick or when we maybe someone dies and we're so sad, or maybe somebody loses a job and they're anxious and worried and they don't know what to do. There are people all around us who are part of God's family who love Jesus. So people we go to church with, people in our family, our brothers and sisters who live with us. And guess what, guys? They need encouragement. They need encouragement. How can we encourage our brothers and sisters in Christ? How can we do it? Can anybody think of a way? Well, we can definitely do it by praying for them. The rest of this week, we're going to hear some verses about how God calls us to pray for. We need to pray for our moms and dads. We need to pray for our grandparents. We need to pray for the people around us who we know love Jesus but need encouragement. So we can definitely pray for them, but we could also make them a card. We could give them a hug. We could pray out loud for them, call them and pray for them over the phone. There are so many ways that we can give them encouragement. We could maybe send them a Bible verse. We could send them a verse that says, you know what? God is with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. Or you could ask your parents to help you find a verse. If someone is sick, there are lots of verses in the Bible about how God is there for the people that are sick, how he wants to heal us. All right? If someone is sad, so sad, there are lots of verses in the Bible about he is there for the brokenhearted. God loves us, and he wants us to show his love to other people. He wants us, just like this verse says, 1 Thessalonians 5:17, therefore encourage each other and build each other up. All right? So today we're going to pray that God gives us the words to send encouragement to the people around us. All right? Dear Jesus, thank you so much. God, today we ask that you help us to be encouraging and building each other up, Lord. If someone is sad or someone is upset or someone needs something, God, help us to see how we can help. Maybe it's to write a card or a note of encouragement. Maybe it's to send them a Bible verse. Maybe it's to pray for them. God, help us to know how we can encourage those around us who love you. And all God's children said, amen. All right, guys, I will see you tomorrow.